We'll kick off. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for staying patient with us. Three projects now, one to go. I'd like to say we saved the best to last, but it's probably not fair on the other groups. My name is Andrew Moore. I'm from One Harvest in Queensland. I'm the business manager up there. Slightly taking a different tack now. As you can see, our title project is Veg Trace Australia, and this is all about growing export opportunities for Australian growers. As we move through the presentation, we'll get an understanding of why we've termed it Veg Trace Australia. Just as a starting point, I'd love to introduce our team that we've been working closely together for the last 6 months. Darren Wood from Monsanto in Victoria, Kim Fan from Four Ways Produce in South Australia, Jamie Alabakis from Fresh Select in Victoria, and Sina Nirkhan from Houston's Farms in Tasmania. As as Roslyn said when we opened the presentation today, this is actually a fairly interactive presentation. If you've had an opportunity to download a QR reader, that's great. If you haven't yet, please have a crack and do it now. It only takes about 30 seconds. By no means is it compulsory. You can keep it for the presentation if you don't have a chance to do it. I'll give you a brief introduction to our presentation today. Sina will work through the opportunities that we've identified. Darren will work through our meat industry case study as a bit of a comparison to what we've planned today. And then Kim and Jamie will work through our traceability and IT platform, and then we'll work through some recommendations going forward. So where did we start with? So obviously we started this project about 6 months ago. We all put our hands up to work on an export strategy. We didn't really know what that looked like at the time. Our research took us in a certain direction. So we certainly know there is a growing interest by Australian growers in the export industry. We want to be able to somehow create further opportunities for Australian growers. And one area that we sort of identified is we want to get away from that oversupply state that seems to put a lot of pressure on the domestic market pricing. And we want to get to a point where the export industry is treated as a long-term strategy rather than an opportunity stumped ground. So getting to that marketing culture rather than a trading culture. We know that businesses that have made this change are enjoying a lot of success. Just using One Harvest as an example, we export a lot of pre-packed beetroot and we're getting a lot of success in especially Southeast Asia, areas such as South Korea, Thailand, Taiwan and Japan. So where do we start as sort of the next step? So in 2016, the HIA, in conjunction with the Australian Federal Government, published a report titled The Vegetable Industry Export Strategy. We sort of pulled that apart and identified some sort of three key areas and three key learnings. So we looked at the current state of the Australian vegetable export industry. We've identified some top line opportunities. And we've also summarised the export market opportunity for an assessment potential. So what do we know about the current market or the current state of play? We know there's increased consumer demand for high quality, safer vegetable products from trustworthy sources. And that's driven by the rising middle and affluent classes in Asia. It's particularly evident in areas such as the Middle East and also India. Increasing rates of Asian-based tourism to Australia is driving a local appetite for Australian produce. We know that through the tourism market in Australia, especially the Asian and Middle Eastern tourists are coming to Australia, they're consuming our produce, they want to be able to access it when they go back home. We know still to this day there's a lack of trust in products from China, just as an example, and this remains extremely high, despite obvious advances in cereal. Darren will touch on that using the powdered milk as an example. Conversely, Australia, Australia has an image of being clean, safe, and having robust regulatory systems. And in some markets, we know that there are segments that consumers will pay 300% premiums for the assurance that comes from Australian grown products. So we've written about five KPIs, not the traditional KPIs, but just to sense check ourselves to make sure we're on the right path. So does the export market exist? Is there demand for Australian produce? Is there a lack of trust from some local supply? Can Australian growers reach these markets? And are overseas consumers willing to pay a premium? Well, we think the simple answer to all of those five questions is yes. So that's taking us to the next stage. So then we've identified what is the major challenge that we need to overcome to support Australian growers for their export strategy. What we believe as a team is traceability. And traceability will form the context of our presentation today. So knowing that, we've written a bit of a mission statement for ourselves, and that is to grow the Australian horticultural export market through improved traceability and education of global retailers and consumers. And we're going to do that through our aim, which is to give retailers and consumers the ability to trace their vegetable purchase, to educate and understand the quality of the Australian horticultural industry. Just two key points I want to point out there. It's not about the consumer, not just about the consumer, it's all about the retailer as well. We want to be able to give confidence and assurance that the high premium that these overseas retailers and consumers are paying, that they are actually getting Australian grown products. And we think the solution that we've come to today will give that level of reassurance and confidence. I'll pass on to Sina, who will detail the opportunity at hand.